This is Gus Summers, and you're watching In Show Celebrities. This is the time I take every Monday to talk about some of my favorite films and actors. This week, we have another great star of Hollywood, Mr. Ben Stiller. He is a son of Jerry Stiller and Ann Miara, great actors and comedians of Hollywood. They would take him all sorts of places as a young man. He said that he had an unusual childhood, truly an entertainer's life early on. Well, right away he would begin to have interest in movie making. As a young boy, he would make films with his sister on the family's Super 8 camera. And even at the age of 9, he made his television debut on his mother's television show. But really, it was in high school that he decided that comedy was what he was going to pursue. So after graduating high school, he went back and forth from New York and LA, studying film and acting, and then finally decided to settle in New York. And he got himself a part in a Broadway play, and that's when he would meet someone who would become a lifelong friend and a true mentor. Mr. John Mahoney. You probably remember him as the dad from the television show Frasier. Well, they became such good friends that when Ben Stiller wanted to make some short films, it was John Mahoney who agreed to star in them. Well, the films were so good that he started to get offers from some of the big television production houses, like Saturday Night Live wanted him to be one of their writers and a part of the cast. MTV also wanted him, and Fox, you know, allowed him to produce music videos. He even had a TV show that had a nice little run. But from all that work, he would really get his first Hollywood break as a director in the film Reality Bites. And it was after that film that he really started, you know, pursuing feature films. Well, first up is a film that he produced and also starred in. It's a dramedy. It isn't quite a comedy, but it's like falls in a weird genre because it's there are funny parts, but it's also like it's like real. The film Tropic Thunder. Well, let me first give you the star-studded cast in the film. So you have Ben Stiller as Tug Speedman, you know, the world's number one action star. Then you have Kurt Lazarus, Robert Downey Jr. He's the thespian of the group. And then you have Jeff Portnoy, Jack Black. He is the raunchy comedy guy, you know, who makes all the, you know, all the terrible films that, you know, breaking millions of dollars. You have Al Pacino. He's the rapper of the group. He's getting his break in the film. Brandon T. Jackson. And then you have Kevin Sandusky, you know, the young guy of the whole group. Jay Baruchel. But that's just the main cast of Tropic Thunder and the fictitious movie in the movie. But then you also have the supporting cast. Listen to this. You have Tom Cruise as Grossman. He is the studio executive that hard-wined and has to have everything his way. And then you have Beck, Ben Stiller's agent, Matthew McConaughey. Just as crazy as ever in the parts. And then you have Underwood, he's the pyrotechnic guy, you know, that likes to blow up everything. Danny McBride. And then you also have Fourleaf. He's the Vietnam veteran whose book they're using as the basis for their movie. Nick Nolte. And then you have the guy who's trying to hold everything together, the director, Cockburn. Steve Coogan. You know, these are the supporting casts. So the film, like I said, is based off the memoir of Fourleaf, Nick Nolte. He talks about how he was in Vietnam, and he had his hands blown off, he has these hooks. You see the opening part of the film, which you don't realize is a movie set. You know, there it looks like it's a real movie, and they're really Vietnam veterans, you know, being hunted down by the Viet Cong, and you know, they're trying to save their fellow soldiers and everything. And then as the movie goes on, you realize that it is actually a movie set. And Ben Stiller, his Tug Speedman, you know, the number one action star, is being criticized by Robert Downey Jr. because, you know, he's already won 5 Oscars and has done all these, you know, art house films, and you know, he's such a great actor. And they're bickering back and forth. You can't cry. You're not giving me anything. Look at him, this guy can't even do these simple techniques. You know, like going back and forth. You know, and everyone else is, you know, just caught up in the middle of their little storm. And Steve Coogan is, you know, we got to keep rolling. And you have Danny McBride, and hey, you guys got to get it. You guys got to have this scene done because the jets are already coming, who are going to drop napalm and blow up everything. So you have all this. And this is just the beginning of the film. And Danny McBride's like, yeah, drop it. They drop it. Cost millions of dollars, and they didn't even have the cameras rolling. That's just the beginning of the film. And so, you know, you see Tom Cruise call, you know, what's going on over there? He's telling Steve Coogan, you're an idiot. You can't get it done. You better get these actors in line or you're all fired. So what ends up happening is Nick Nolte and Steve Coogan meet, and Nick Nolte says, you know what you got to do is you got to take them to the jungle, drop them in there, and just film their responses so that way it looks real. And Steve Coogan says, oh great, we'll do it guerrilla style, we'll just put cameras everywhere and we'll see how they react, and we'll get the footage that way. So he takes them without telling him what he's doing. Danny McBride has, you know, put all sorts of booby traps. Nick Nolte, you know, they all fly him in the helicopter. All the actors come jump out. Steve Coogan jumps out, the helicopters leave. He goes, all right, now you guys got to really do it because they're gone. I'm the only one who has a phone to communicate to come get them, come get us. So you guys got to do it. And he ends up, they end up, they're actually in, in Vietnam. And he steps on a landmine and gets killed. So they think it's part of the movie. And so the explosion, they hear people coming from the nearby drug facility because they're guarding it. And so they're seeing who these guys are. He goes, hey, we have the military here. But the cast think it's part of the movie. So he said, he didn't really blow up. Look at Ben Stiller gets his head. Look at it's fake. And he puts it on his gun. Look at it. And the guys think they're crazy, the other soldiers. And Robert Downey Jr. saying, this isn't fake. This is real. And so you know, they escape that. They're trekking through the jungle. Robert Downey Jr. says, you're crazy. He goes, no, look, everything that's happened is part of the script. They're trying to get the best performances out of us. He goes, you're crazy. So that's just the beginning of the film. We're not even talking about when they get captured, when they decide to go, you know, their own way. And Robert Downey Jr. doesn't break character. Ben Stiller says, if this isn't real, why are you still in character? I'm always in character, you know, even up to the commentary. And just his performance, he's portrayed, Robert Downey Jr. is portrayed to be black. So he has black face and he keeps the accent going. I mean, great. It's not even a comedy because it's, you know, they get into real situations that they have to figure out as real people. But it's kind of a comedy because, you know, you have all these people doing funny things. Nick Nolte's crazy. Danny McBride's crazy. You know, like I said, Robert Downey Jr. doesn't get out of character. But, you know, it's the funny elements that make it more of a comedy than anything. Well, next up is a movie that he just recently did. And it's a slice of life of someone who is stuck in the same routine, decides to get out of it. The movie, The Secret Life of Walter P. Mitty. He plays, obviously, Walter Mitty. He is a negative asset manager at Life magazine. He's the one who goes through all the photos and, you know, passes on to the people to put in the magazine. Well, Life is closing the print and going to online. So there's a transition. He's afraid that a lot of people are afraid that they're going to get fired. they have the photographer who's basically their famed photographer. His name is Sean O'Connell, played by Sean Penn. And so in the midst of being closing down live, Sean Penn sends his roll of film. He goes, there's one photo, 25, that is pretty much the epitome of what life has been up to this time. And the new boss tells Walter Piumetti, where's this photo? And they don't know what happened to it. So Ben Stiller's telling him, well, you know, it's fine. It's going through process. I'll get it to you. And he says, well, you better get it to me. Guy plays a jerk. So anyways, he realizes he has to, no one knows where it's at. He has a love interest that she doesn't know that he likes her. He finally goes up to her because she may be able to help him to find the picture. And her name is Cheryl, played by Kristen Wiig. So he asks her, can you find out where his checks are sent to? And so on and so forth. Maybe I can track him down. Well, she finds out that he's in Greenland. And he just decides, I'm going to go and, you know, get this photo. So he tries to make his way to Greenland, find that he's not there. He left on some boat. He gets on this helicopter and he has to jump. The guy says, well, you know, if you want to get on the ship, you have to jump to the boat. And he jumps out, but he didn't realize there was another small boat that was going to be there waiting for him. He goes, no, not the pilot. He's drunk. He's like, not the big boat, the little boat. He jumps in the water. It's shark infested. He has to fight the shark. And so in the midst of, you know, this adventure of him trying to find Sean Penn, he's trying to open an account on eHarmony so he can ask Kristen Wiig out through eHarmony. So the voice on the phone saying, what? Why don't you just ask her out? He's like, no, I don't want to do that way. I want to do it something special. So he's dealing with eHarmony. The eHarmony guy thinks he's crazy because, you know, he hasn't done anything in his life. And then his name's Todd. The voice, you end up seeing him later. Todd is Patton Oswalt. So Patton Oswalt said, you got to do more stuff with your life. So as he's going with the adventure, Todd's calling him and said, hey, you know, what have you been doing? He goes, well, you know, I just went to Greenland. I jumped into shark-infested water. So I'm on a frigate. You know, I escaped. He ended up going to this town. Sean Penn wasn't there. There was an eruption with the volcano. And he goes, well, I just escaped a volcano. Wow, this is great. You know, Patton's Oswalt. Yeah, well, this is what we're talking about. And so you see him slowly pursue Sean Penn in the midst discovering about himself. You know, what is life about? And, you know, he doesn't want to do something, and his love for Kristen Wiig inspires him to go, you know, pursue, you know, this adventure. So he ends up basically tracking the world looking for Sean Penn. So in the midst of him doing a self-discovery, his job is being jeopardized. He has to help his mother move. And so, you know, you have to watch it through the end. It was a great movie. I know you'll enjoy it. You know, all of these. You know, I'm not even talking about some of his other great films like Night of the Museums, Meet the Parents, Zoolander, Something About Mary, and of course, Dodgeball. Dodgeball, I love that film. Great film. It's a great fallback just to, you know, watch something entertaining. Well, that's what I got for you today. This has been Gus Summers, and you've been watching In Show Celebrities. This is the time I take every Monday to talk about some of my favorite films and actors. Of course, remember, don't forget to visit every Thursday at theinshow.com, where I host The In Show, and I bring on sorts of celebrities and guests to talk about their projects or whatever it is they want to talk about. Of course, visit us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Flickr, Instagram, all those great social media sites. And as always, ladies and gentlemen, Gus has left.